started in darkness. As chaos ensued, maybe something like your life, because that sounds a lot like mine too. And with just the sound of his voice, just a few simple words, the greatest metaphors we know, light and darkness were formed. And God, my words couldn't dream of the impact of yours, but right here, right now, speak through me, I'm yours. Father, forgive me. I've said it 1,000 times and I'm never quite sure if it's working. Because they say that your love is as big as my mind can wrap around, and even bigger, some say, on the days that I'm down. But this magnitude scares me, and I'm afraid that I'll drown. So I'll just keep swimming in this puddle I've made, in my mind like a chasm, a tiny raft on a tidal wave. You are so much bigger than my mind lets me see, and you love so much better than any person I'll meet. And our flesh tears holes in the peace of our existence. Our own bodies like zombies eat us away upon resistance. And I can't stand to think of the things that I've done, but then again, you don't. You've thrown them away and they're gone. But you see, this God that you speak of seems so far away, but there's people out there that swear that he knows my name and the hairs on my head and the dreams of my heart, but there is absolutely no way that he made this and called it art. See, Paul said it perfectly. I am the worst of these, but every now and again, I swear I've got that guy beat. And I stole that from a brother, and I'm sure he won't mind, because that's the least of the darkness that I'm hiding inside, because you don't know what I've done. If hate in my heart equals murder on this earth, then lock me up, throw away the key, put me in a straitjacket, cause I'm a killer. I've watched hate creep into my eyes as I look at the people that I call my friends, and I don't even remember all my victims' names. But you still love me. Forgiveness at its finest, hanging on a tree, a man living blameless died for you and for me, and yet I have to remind myself of that almost by the minute, cause I can't seem to hold myself together long enough for it to sink in. But you see, death, that's not the end. That's not the last chapter. That's not the towel thrown in. The Son of God came and he died and he rose again. And that's the reason I can stand here today. Forgiven and free and blameless in every way. And I know what you're thinking, not this again, but listen. Trust me when I tell you that it's way easier for me to tell you Jesus loves you than for me to believe that he'd love a guy like me. And I promise, I swear that the Jesus you know, he doesn't care about money or putting on a show, and he's nothing like me or your preacher or your mom. And I know that we've all representative law. We've lied, we've cheated, we've hated and cursed. But those same mouths proclaim the beauty of birth. And I'm sorry for the people out there, including me, who've painted Jesus upside down for you. As hard as it is to believe that anything is real at this point, there's a God who loves you and he knows how you feel and he longs for and waits for and wants only you, and deep down inside you know that you need him too. So don't ignore that stirring that you're feeling right now. Don't let it end when I take a bow. Listen to a God who loves you more than you know, more than your dad who left you, or that man that just throws you away like you're trash, says he'll find someone new. Jesus died so you could feel love. And he died for him too. So today begins the start of eternity. And the good news is we only last about 80 years or maybe 100, because I'm so sick of this body and the pains of this place. But I know that he's coming, and some days it seems like a race. Jesus is coming to make all things new, to throw away the pains of this world and this body. No crying, no hurting, no knives in the back. He's coming to renew us. And I hope he gets here soon.